What's going on, guys? It's Buffalo Rob checking back in with you today, and we're going to be doing a blitz scheme from the 4-6 normal formation. We're going to start out with the right side first, and what we're going to do is we're going to start with picking the 4-6 normal and the cover 3. Now, this setup will work with any play that you select from the 4-6 normal formation, so keep that in mind to adjust your coverages. What you're going to want to do is baseline, show blitz, spread the line, and use an edge rush. And then after you crash the line up, you're going to re-blitz the defensive end and the defender in the gap behind the D-tackle on the side that you want the blitz to come from. In this case, we're going to be blitzing the D-end on the right and the gap defender, and we're going to get the right defensive end in free. Just to show you one more time, we're going to baseline, show blitz, spread the line and edge rush, re-blitz the right defensive end and the gap defender on the right, and we're going to get the right defensive end in free. Now, what you're going to want to be able to do is bring this blitz from the left side, giving the same look in order to confuse your opponent. So what you're going to want to do is baseline, show blitz, spread the line and edge rush. Now, in this case, you're going to be re-blitzing the left defensive end and the gap defender on the left side. It is a little bit harder to get the blitz in on this side, so if you're having trouble getting it in, you can see what I'm doing is I'm bringing over a defender on the right, whether it be the gap defender or the safety, and kind of distracting the offensive line there on the right side of the screen. Just because of the way that the formation is unbalanced, the blitz does not work as effectively on the left side unless you bring somebody down. Now, once your opponent decides that they're not going to be able to stop the blitz, they're probably going to shift the line to the right, shift the line to the left, or maybe block the running back. Once you see them blocking the running back, what you can do is you can baseline, show blitz, spread the line and edge rush, re-blitz both ends and both gap defenders. And what you're going to see here is we're going to be able to get in both defensive ends free at the same time. So if the running back was to be blocking, he's only going to be able to pick up one of them. The other one is going to come in free after the quarterback. One more time, what we're going to do, baseline, show blitz, re-blitz the both outside guys and the gap defenders after you spread the line and crash up, and you're going to get both defenders in free. Now, there's a whole bunch of things that you can do with this setup, and there's if you can mess around with those guys on the outside in the slots, and you can get them in free as well, but I seem to think that way was the best way to do it. Now, what's a little bit of an edge rush without a little A-gap fun? So what we're going to do here, guys, is we're going to baseline, show blitz. You can see me shift the defensive line to the right. And what you're going to do from left of the screen to the right side of the screen is you're going to put the left defensive end in a purple zone. You're going to put the defensive tackle over the center in a spy. And you're going to put the right defensive end in a quarterback contain. And then re-blitz the right gap defender, as you can see there. So what you're doing is you're sending basically a two-man rush with a spy and a contain. And you're going to be able to get a three-man edge rush. Remember, you need speed at that D-tackle position for it to work. Guys, it's Buffalo Rob. I'm checking out. As usual, I'll talk to y'all. And if you want your own scheme, leave it in the comments section below. Peace.